Let's talk about histamine intolerance. What is that? Well, first of all, a histamine is involved in the immune system. It's also present in certain foods. And if you had damage to your stomach or your intestines, you could be deficient in this enzyme, diamine oxidase. And this is the enzyme that helps you break down histamines. And because histamines are in certain foods, when you eat certain foods, these are the symptoms that you can experience. Headaches, migraines, your sinuses get stuffy, diarrhea, asthma, palpitations of the heart, skin gets flushed and red, hives, itchiness, vertigo, you're dizzy when you stand up, or low blood pressure. These foods over here are high in histamines. Pretty much all the fermented foods, wines, vinegar. However, apple cider vinegar is less than balsamic vinegar and other types of vinegar. Aged cheeses, cured meats, alcohol, avocados. Now I know this is a keto-friendly food, but it has higher amounts of histamines. Canned foods, chocolate, black tea, eggs, mustard, nuts, soy, spinach, strawberries, and tomato. And there's others as well, but this list will give you an idea of the most common foods that are high in histamines. So two questions. Number one, how do you know if you have a histamine intolerance? And number two, what do you do about it? Well, just start eating some of these foods and see if you get any of these reactions, okay? That will pretty much tell you if you have a histamine intolerance. All right, so now let's talk about what to do. Number one, you want to replace some of these foods with foods that are low in histamines, okay? I gave you a list right here. Asparagus, bell pepper, blueberries, cabbage, cauliflower, grass-fed beef, green leafy vegetables, excluding spinach, turkey, white fish, green tea, liver, squash, and zucchini. If you eat these foods, you're gonna feel a lot better. These symptoms should go away if you're truly deficient in this enzyme. So that's number one. Number two, you wanna consume a supplement or something that has this enzyme in it. And it just so happens that grass-fed kidney has that enzyme. So if you were to buy a product, and I'm not gonna give you any brands, you can research that. If you were to buy a product that has a grass-fed kidney extract, that will give you the enzyme and you're gonna feel a lot better when you consume some of these foods. Now, another product that has that enzyme is liverwurst. You can get that from US Wellness Meats. It's grass-fed, very high quality. I'll put a link down below. I don't get any kickbacks from that, just FYI. All right, the next thing that you wanna do is periodic prolonged fasting. Like every 2 weeks, you fast for 48 hours. In addition to intermittent fasting, why? Because you wanna heal the gut so you don't have a problem with this anymore, and so your body can make this enzyme. Fasting is the best way to basically grow a new gut lining, including supporting your stomach as well. And lastly, you want to do number five, fix the digestion. Yes, you want to do the fasting, but there's other things you can do to support digestion as well. Supplements, probiotic. I'm gonna put a video down below so you can do some more research on the digestion. All right, guys, so that's a quick summary of histamine intolerance. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely, you have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.